Hello guys, my name is Amit. So today we are going to discuss about Bookmyshow. And in Bookmyshow, I had a question that how the booking is held on Bookmyshow. So for example, I'll just give you what I mean. So for example, if I am in Bookmyshow, something as activities, explore activities or something, maybe movies or something. So if I click here, and then let me just try to book this event. I'll not book it, but I'm just showing what the problem here is, means what we are going to discuss here. So what we are discussing is that if I try to book a ticket on Bookmyshow, maybe something like this. So if I click here, then for how many seconds, and I'll not discuss about the time, but how this booking is holded. So if I do a continue, let me add max capacity. So only 10 tickets. Let me add confirm. So it asks me to provide the details or something. Now let me try to open the same from my phone and see what happens. So see here. So I'm on the same link here, and if I try to open it, so this is showing orange here. If you can see, this is showing orange here, and this orange means the middle 26 June booking. It means that I have booked it from my side. Someone is already booking it. If I'll just click it and continue it, sorry. So as we can see, it says fast filling. So how this feature is actually achieved, this one. And if I try to go back, let maybe cancel the booking. Let me cancel the booking. So now booking is cancelled. Let me cancel it. And then when I come back here, it again shows green. So how this feature is achieved, how this, if you can see this, this comes green. So how this feature is achieved actually. Let me just discuss that. So I was just giving a thought on it, how this might be achieved. So how this might be achieved is that if I have a Bookmyshow user or maybe Bookmyshow. So if you want to go through the Bookmyshow complete design, I'll just include this in my GitHub page as well. So this is the Bookmyshow complete design. I have included a image here as well. Okay, so let's come back to this problem. So how this might be getting achieved is on a browser or on an app, when user goes into the Bookmyshow, he selects the country, he selects the city, then he selects the area, then he selects the theater. So once the theater is selected, the query might be sent to the app server. And this query would be a JSON query or a XML query. So JSON query looks something like this. We have key and value pairs. Similarly, XML query is bit similar. So what might be going in the JSON or the XML query is the theater name, and it will get a XML or a JSON document. So what kind of the document must be? Let me try to. So the JSON document must be having something. If our theater has five, let's consider our theater has five rows as A, B, C, D, and E, and it has each row has, I think, somewhere around 5 seats. We can consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this would be A1, then this would be A2, and so on, right? And then this would be A3, and so on. So on the application server, on Bookmyshow, this he'll be having the information that which seats are filled or not. So what he'll do is, for this particular theater, he'll create a JSON document, something as, if let's consider this first seat is booked, so he'll send it as 1. If this A2 is not booked, he'll send it at 0. And if this is under waiting, like under the orange status which we seen, so it might send it 2, something similar. So maybe these seats are empty, this one is also empty, something like this, right? So what he'll do is, he'll just this app or the browser will just read this information from the JSON document, will interpret that these are the seats, these are the rows, and these are the columns, and just represent the same data onto the user page. Now the user will have the information that hey, seat number 2 is getting filled, these seats are empty. So now once the user selects the seat and tries to pay, but he has not paid yet. The point is, not paid yet. Okay, so now again, when he tries to, he has selected it and tries to pay but not paid, then again a message might be getting sent to the app server, and app server will be maintaining two queues there. So one would be the ready queue, which contains seats to be booked. So in this ready queue, we'll have this one, 3 here, because this is somewhere near to getting booked, and there will be one done queue. So whenever someone pays, so the seats would be moved from ready queue to done queue. And while this JSON document in which the information is sent to the user, OR operation is done on them, that is, both are combined, ready queue and done queue. So this is something as ready queue or done queue, and the data is sent. So in OR, all the 1s, 2s and 0s except 0s are actually captured, and those will be sent to it. So now once he pays it, the entry will be moved to done queue, and the data might be sent again in the XML or JSON format, and then it will be again displayed by the user. So I believe this is how the system might be working. So that's it for